G'day folks, today we're drawing a cobra. I did a how to draw a cobra in the last video, and I find the how to draw ones kind of limiting in that I have to explain every little step and try and simplify it. So whereas this, I'm just cutting loose, drawing it the way I want to draw it. Let's dive in deep. Starting off with a pencil. This is just a, what is it, a 4B? Probably. So worn off I can't see what it is. Pencil, all I'm doing is marking out the lines. These lines are all going to disappear because I'm going to ink it like a comic book, like an illustration. And after the inks, I'm going to rub out all the lines. Then we're going to move on to paint. Okay, so here I've got one of my fine liners here. No, you can't see that, can you? It's going to focus. You can see it's just got this really slightly longer bristles, very flexible. It's fine. It's my favourite brush for doing the ink work. It flows a little bit, but it's still short enough to have a bit of control. Right, delving into the Indian ink. So this piece is going to be halfway between realism and cartoony look. I just love the nice big bold outline. I've marked these scales out pretty good. They're fairly accurate. That's all the brushwork done. Now it's down to the drawing nib. Love these things. This drives some people crazy, I know, but I used to find that the marker pens used to like fade. They'd go blue, they'd go brown. It was never archival. And so I always went with this because it was better quality. And after years of using this, I'm just sort of used to nibs. I can only do so much work. After an hour or two, my eyes get a bit fuzzy and it's time to go outside. Luckily I've got a big backyard. So this is my backyard. Nice backyard, isn't it? When I've been looking at a drawing for hours and hours and hours, your eyes sort of get very tired. You need to refocus somewhere else. One of the things I used to do as a young man is draw for hours and then play darts. Your eyes would refocus, you're right. Don't have a dartboard anymore, do have a knife. So I just throw knives at a tree. Sounds like one of my neighbours has got power tools. Right. Yes.
Too low. Too low.
Thanks for giving myself some fresh air, a bit of a stretch, a bit of exercise, and importantly, focused my eyes further away than just right here. So, handy hint for all you artists out there, working for a long time here, take a break, refocus your eyes. Throwing darts is good, throwing a knife is good, gives you that feeling of depth perception. You've got to pace out a certain amount, throw that knife, get it just right so it'll stick in a tree. After a bit of that, you're ready to go back into the studio and do some more drawing of this cobra drawing I'm doing. Alright, just one more. Enjoying this. Yes! Perfect one. Always good to finish on a good one. Dead center. Pretty keen to get back into this cobra drawing. Get back into it. Fresh eyes. Okay, now I'm looking at this, I'm thinking that what I might do is just go straight in the watercolour. I think a lot of the fine lines I'm doing is going to get covered with paint anyway. So, slam it straight into watercolour. Let's go. That's me done. I'm pretty tired. I need to have a rest from this anyway, but I think I'm finished. I'll let that dry and just have it in my portfolio. Now, as you see, I get up and move about a bit. I don't sit down all day long, although it has been a few hours here. What do you guys do? Let us know in the comments below, and thanks for watching the video all the way through. See you in the next video. Watch some of these ones that are going to pop up on the screen here. If you're on a desktop, if you're not on a desktop computer, you're probably wondering what I'm pointing to. See you next time. Bye.